Everyone, welcome to Short Sales Classes. Hope you all are doing fine. So today, since the B-Stat is near, I have taken the initiative to solve problems from Test of Mathematics for the aspirants of Indian Statistical Institute entrance examination. Those who are new to this, I must say that this video series is meant for aspirants of Indian Statistical Institute and Chennai Mathematical Institute entrance examination at the bachelor's level. Indian Statistical Institute, I don't need to tell, it is, you already know that it is one of the most prestigious institutes, and for that, we qualified for that prestigious institute, and to get an honor to study there, you need to clear their entrance examination. Now, to clear their entrance examination, the paper pattern was discussed in past videos, you can check it. And the most important thing that you must do to clear the ISI entrance examination is, yes, so what you need to do is, the most compulsory thing you need to do is, you need to get this book immediately. So this book, as you can see, the name is Test of Mathematics at 10 plus 2 level. It is published by Indian Statistical Institute themselves. The press is East West Press, so you can get this book easily on any bookstore. Or even if you don't get it on bookstore, you can just buy it on Amazon or Flipkart. This book is available at very low prices. And this book contains lots and lots of problems for practice. So this book, as published by Indian Statistical Institute themselves, for the entrance examination, you can imagine that how much important it is to be familiarized with the questions of this book. So practically every ISI aspirant must have this book compulsorily. And this book is the just the bible of questions from the ISI that the type of questions that will appear in your exam. So we have chosen this book as our reference, and we are solving problems from this book so that you can excel in the examination. So the first question for the class is, so it says that S is equal to 1 plus 11 plus 111. So let me shift the camera a bit upward. 111 plus 1111 plus 8, so on. So the question asks for the sum S. So it gives you four options, and one of the four options is correct. So I give you a stipulated time to solve this question. Okay, so the stipulated time that is been for this question is over. So now we will come to discussing the problem. So I guess that many of you could have done it. So now what I do is, I just get on with the solution. So before I get on with the solution, let me give you a motivation for this problem. Now, you can easily get the pattern right, that the number of ones is increasing by one at its stage. So here there are two ones, here there are three ones, here there are four ones. And now when you see such a question, the first thing that should come in your mind is the GP series. So I hope that everyone have thought of this GP series, but the thing is that you couldn't apply to it. You couldn't think of a suitable method that can be applied for those who couldn't solve the problem. Now, for the application of this GP series, we need to do a very simple trick. Now, what is that trick? Observe that, so let me rub up the options for now. Now, for that trick to be applied and to transform this into a GP series, what I do is that I multiply both sides by 1 over 9. So, I just don't multiply, sorry. So what I do is just a slight tricky rearrangement. How that, so that it can be converted into a GP series. So this is just, you can say, a tricky rearrangement. So what I do is that I take 1 by 9 common and write it as 9. So I hope you had no problem in understanding this step. So what I did is that I took 1 by 9 common and I just write the sum as 9, 9, 9, 9, 9 triple 9, 4 times 9 and so on up to n 9s. So how did I do it? The first question that comes in our mind is how did I do it? And the second is why did I do it? So I could have taken 1 by 8 and wrote it as 8, 8, 8, 8, 8, 8 and so on. So the first question is how did I do it? So if you just see this, that this is a very important, very easy step to verify and also a very important step. That if you multiply this 9 by this 9 it comes 1, this 9 by this 9 it comes 11, this 9 by the 3 9s it comes 1 1 1 and this 9 by the 4 9s it comes 1 1 1. So our series doesn't change. So I can do it. So this is how I do it. Now to answer the second question, why did I do it? I want you to just point your eyes to draw your attention to a single point. 9 is basically 10 minus 1, isn't it? 99 is basically 100 minus 1, which is nothing but 10 square minus 1. Okay, 999 is basically 1000 minus 1. Okay, and so on it goes. So you observe the pattern, it's just 10 square, 10 cube, the third term becomes 10 power 4 and the fifth term becomes 10 power 5 and so on. And we have got the GP series of our choice that we were looking for. And now since the sum of GP is known, we can easily now solve the problem on our own. So let's just try solving the problem. So this can be written as, okay, so how many ones are here? N1, so these N1s can be transposed outside. Okay, and now this simple evaluation results to, so this GP series, we know already the what the sum of the GP series is. So it's, okay, and this is the answer for the problem. So you see that this problem didn't require any special steps, or you can say any special things, except this part. So I would encourage you to remember or just understand the technique of this part so that you can apply in future problems, because you can't always expect that this same problem will be given to you right in the examination hall. So you need to familiarize with these tricks so that you can get out with the problem that is similar to this. So maths is all about how we can relate things. So how did I solve this problem? I didn't previously approach this problem. So the fact is that I solved a problem of similar type earlier, and I could relate that earlier concept to here what I'm solving right now. So this relation to solve in problem solving in mathematics is very important. Okay, so now I'll get on with the second question.
Okay, so we are back with the second problem, and
the second problem says in an AP, the sum of the first, the ratio of the sum of first n terms and to the sum of the next n terms is n square by n square,
So it is given that the ratio of the sum of the first m terms to n terms is n square by n square. That is the ratio of the term number squared.
And the 13th term is given as 50. Then find, so I just miswrote this too. So then find the 26th term. So there is an AP given whose ratio of the first m and the first n terms are known, and it is given that the 13th term is 50, and to find the 26th term. So I give you a stipulated amount of time to solve this problem. Okay, so the stipulated time that was meant for this question is over, and now I'll solve the question for you. So this was a very straightforward question, I must say, which can be solved very easily. So I just solved it directly without giving you any motivation. This is because I think that the question has enough motivation to be solved. So what is given is that SM n square by n square, which implies, so we know that what is the sum of the first n terms. We just directly put the formula. Substituting the formula and just cancelling it from both sides, give it. And now what we do is that we just divide by 2. Both sides. Just the numerator and denominator of this side is divided by 2. And what I get is now I know that what is the 13th term, and the 13th term for an AP is always of the form n plus 12b. So for that I need to choose m as 25. So choosing n as 25, I get t13 by, so 25 minus, so n, what I choose is, I need the 26th term, so I just choose n to be 53, so then I get the 26th term, so m I choose 25 and n is 53. Okay, sorry, I think I made a mistake. Sorry, m I choose to be, so I just need to equate m minus 1 by 2 to be 12. That makes m as 25, and m minus 1 by 2 to be 25, and I need to choose here 51. So 51 by 25, so 25 by 51, and the answer is, say, so T13 by T26 is 25 by 51, and T13 is given, so T13 is 50. So my answer is just this. I cancel it out, and so 102. So I got the 26 term to be 102. Now what did I do basically in the problem? In this problem I basically need the 13th term. So just without loss, I just give the substitute m so that I can get 12d. Because I can do that. I can do that. This is because this was a part of the question. It was given in the question. So I can substitute m and n as my choice. So, but as my choice doesn't mean that I substitute randomly any amount. So since it is as my choice, so I just take the full advantage to get the 13th term here. And similarly, I can find the 26th term by safely picking the n, so safely choosing the n. And hence I get T26 as 102. So today we have solved two problems, and I have given you some very special concepts and tricks. So I just tell you that please don't just stop at these tricks, solve more and more problems from desktop mathematics of this type, of this pattern, using these tricks. And the fact is that the serious aspirants of ISI who are appearing must not be restricted to tomato only. So they must practice something more. So for that something more, that questions that goes parallel to ISI and CMI, Saurabh says classes provides exquisite quality of study materials that you can get a copy of your own immediately and start practicing the problems to just clear the examination with flying colors. So that's all for today. Thank you for staying tuned with us. Best of luck for your exams and stay well. Thank you.